When I was an undergrad, I was a biology major, and I spent a summer working in a neuroscience lab, and that really just sparked my interest and got me really excited. And after I graduated from undergrad, I worked as a technician for a few years in that lab, and I realized that this is the path I want to go down. So I went to grad school and stuck to neuroscience, and I'm here. This is where I am. These medium spiny neurons are located in the striatum, both the dorsal striatum and ventral striatum. And I'm really focused on the ventral striatum, which is also known as the nucleus accumbens, because it plays a big role in addiction behaviors. It's this maladaptive responses in drug addiction. We see a lot of neurobiological changes in this region. However, there's multiple cell types in that region that are intermixed, and you can't really distinguish these different cell types. So I use a technique called optogenetics, and what optogenetics involves is expressing these light-activated proteins. In this case, I'm using a protein called channel rhodopsin. It's a cation channel. So when you shine a blue light on this channel, the channel opens and allows positive ions to flow into the cell, and that can turn on a neuron, turn on its activity. So we can use these channel rhodopsins to selectively express them in either medium spiny neuron population, and then selectively activate one population, turn on one population versus the other, and then look at these two neurons, the role of these two neurons in addiction behaviors. The clinical potential of this work is that we now know that we really need to focus on distinct subtypes. In the human brain, we need to find therapies that can specifically modulate one subtype over the other. In this case, possible therapeutics that can manipulate activity in either cell subtype. And that might be a better way to approach these diseases, to just focus on move from the heterogeneous brain to a more specific neuronal population, and focus on those specific neurons and treat those in addiction behaviors.